For this to sort of set up. There we go. But this camera has a hard time focusing sometimes. Yeah, I don't know what it is. I was reading up on this that both the Sony and the Canon, their autofocus isn't as good as it should be. So, anyway, let me give you the time and date stamp. It is 13 hours and 31 minutes into the day of Friday, October 31st. It is officially Halloween. Yay for that. everyone's going to be going out for Halloween tonight or doing something for Halloween. No, I'm not. I'm going to be spending most of my time here at my research desk. Well, not really. I'm still in a shutdown mode. Although things are getting a lot better, they're not as bad as they used to be, so I'm happy for that, because, you know, before it was a lot more difficult. Well, if you can only be up for an hour or so, it makes things difficult to get anything done. Your efficiency model has to be working almost perfectly, but things seem to have leveled off. I'm starting to come out of the fatigue stage, the stage where my body wants and needs to rest. And so now I'm going to be going back into possibly Wednesday. Wednesday I'm going to start scheduling some more normal type days. So I'm going to give myself until Wednesday to sort of give myself extra time to catch up on my sleep. Because as soon as Wednesday comes, so I'm back to my normal schedule, is going to be, you know, pushing myself to the absolute limit. I mean, that's what I do here. I push myself to the absolute limit. And this is kind of what you have to do when you're doing the work that I'm doing. When, you know, and I will explain a little bit more in coming vlogs what's going on and where we're going with things. There's an enormous amount of risk to that. I'm doing things that haven't been done before, and so this is kind of where, you know, we got to sort of deal with what's coming along. So, the other thing was this is where my mind cuts out. I'm sitting here all often watching TV, my IPTV, and my IPTV is either anime or YouTube or cartoons. And I was just watching one called More Cat-Terrific. And she was talking about jealousy. And the thing is a lot of people, when I hear particularly on YouTube, when they're trying to talk about these things like jealousy and wonder why people can't, you know, why something is. They're trying to give a logical explanation for emotions like jealousy. But the problem is that jealousy and all other forms of emotion aren't logical. And it's not until you have an emotional understanding of the situation, or call it an emotional grasp, rather than an intellectual grasp. You can intellectualize all you want with the person. You know, the person can have a logical understanding of something, but if the emotion isn't there, in other words, if there's no emotional understanding of this, then the emotion or the lack of emotional control will always win out. So that's kind of where we're going with that. Anyways, I'm going to start bringing more of the stuff in here. I'm organizing my notes for the vlogs, the BTS vlogs better. so not much is going on. Getting ready to go back to bed. I have to do one last bit of hydration to the, and then once that's done, I'm going back to bed again. So that's the sort of the routine for today, the routine for these last few days, and that's going to be like wait, is going to be until Wednesday. It's going to be, I'm going to be in bed a lot, so there's not really going to be much to talk about unless I talk about some of the stuff that's going on YouTube. So anyways, I'll see you in the next segment of the BTS vlog. Well, hello, everybody. Yeah, it's surprisingly, it's twice in one day. I'm doing a vlog. I'm supposed to be sick. Well, I am still knocked out from the sleep deprivation, but things are greatly improving, so that's why I'm here for a second vlog. So let me give you a time and date stamp. It is 20 hours and 24 minutes into the day of Friday, October 31st, 2014. And as I said before, well, I'm in not having a Halloween, but apparently because of the rain, nobody else is having much of a Halloween either. So my solution to not have having a Halloween, because basically I'm old, if you hadn't noticed, is one, I go to the anime conventions. Well, I don't really go. I have the anime conventions if I want to do cosplay and stuff like that. That's my that's for the costumes and dressing up. And then my most immediate concern for Halloween is the candy. And I've learned how to make my own candy. I'm building a small little candy factory, making it part of the kitchen diner. And so yay for that. That's sort of what I'm happy with. So basically what's happened today is that, and this is why I'm vlogging, I was early to watched my Bertaley videos today, my YouTube part. I have the way I've set my YouTube up, the YouTube subscription setup doesn't work too well. If there are shows you particularly want to watch, or channels you want to watch, they don't always pop up when the video uploads. So, because this, particularly if you're subscribed to a lot of channels. The way I've done it is using bookmarks and organized bookmarks. I set up lists on places I want to go. So let's say I have a main place I want to go. Let's say that, so Bertaley is my main place I want to go. And there are a lot of channels that are related to the Bertaley list. And this includes Kitty's Mama. This includes Mommy and Gracie's show. It includes Clintus TV. There's a couple others I can't remember where they are, but I will be talking about them here on a regular basis. This is where I come to watch my TV, because what I have right now is IPTV, and most of the other stuff is gone, really. Well, not really gone, but it's in a different format, and sometimes I watch a lot of cartoons on other services that I have, but then I come back and I watch this a lot, so another, it goes back and forth between what I watch and what I don't watch. One of the lists I have is called a vlogging list. And these are all the vloggers that I really like. And I go back to this vlogging list and see who's there and what they're actually saying. And one of the vlogs I really like a lot is I Justine's sister, Jenna. And she has two vlogs. She has Jenna Vlogs, and then she has Jenna Ezarek, she has the recent vlog where she just got a new place, and she's going shopping to IKEA to see everything. And I thought that I like these shopping vlogs. I like when they're buying stuff for a new place. And a lot of people go to IKEA and then they take it home, and then they try to build it. I saw this on with Kate on her Piddle Dash channel. She had gone out to IKEA and bought some furniture and assembled it and put her furniture together, and she showed building the furniture. And for me, that's a really interesting aspect of things, because that's kind of what I do here, but not exactly the same thing. I'm a freegan. I don't go out to IKEA to buy and build my furniture. I go out to the curbside, where people have left old furniture on the side, bring it back in, refurbish it, and then use it for whatever I want it. And that's what I did tonight. This is sort of what ended my bed rest. As I've been working in the machine shop, where the Toys DIY is going to be filmed. And I got to a point because I found someone had left out for garbage a very nice desk with shelving in it. And I need a mixing unit here for the music studio. I need a mixing unit here that will allow me to put the mixing unit, several other instruments, plus on top, to sit on top of the mixer. I need it to have enough space so that I can put a laptop on here. Because the new system that I'm getting, is going to hook directly into the computer, and then the computer is going to hook into the mixer. And to buy one of these things, it's quite expensive. So I found something in the garbage, got my wagon out, went and picked it up. This is by walking. I have a little wagon that I can take with me. And picked it up, brought it back in. It's now sitting and drying because it was kind of rainy outside. I got to wait for it to dry a little bit more. And then tomorrow, I did rough measurements. Tomorrow I have to go back and do second measurements and sort of size things up and decide how I want to build what I want to build. So I will definitely bring you in on this type of stuff, and you can sort of, you know, see the difference between an IKEA furniture builder and a person who does freegan. I think IKEA costs a lot more. Well, it does cost a lot more, but I don't think what I do is that much more complex compared to what they do in terms of building for IKEA. So our time is up. I will talk to you again, more likely than not tomorrow. So I will see you in the next segment of the BTS vlog. All right, take it easy and goodbye. Well, what do I say? It's time to get started again. Do another daily vlog. Just get everything sort of set up here. It's either called Glutton for Punishment or Obsessive Behavior Traits if you're a geek or a nerd. One of the things that happens to me as a geek or a nerd is that I get into a situation where I start something and I work at it obsessively until I can't go any further. In other words, I can't stop myself. That's an obsessive behavior. So to explain this further, we need a time and date stamp first. And so it is 19 hours and 57 minutes into the day of Saturday, November 1st, 2014. Today I was supposed to go back to the warehouse machine shop and work on my little present, my freaking present, the new furniture that I got. Many people I talked about, Jenna, I think is Jenna Ezra Rick. She's iJustine's sister. They went to IKEA and they're furnishing her new apartment. This other vlogger that I saw, because I like these vlogs, I like these type of vlogs. She's known as Mac Baby 11. She also has a Vlog Baby 11. Her name is Alicia. She's moving into her first apartment. She went to IKEA to pick out furniture as well. And so I was supposed to, and I found some extra furniture. I needed a mixer and instrument rack for my music studio. But I don't have one. And so I found some material out in the garbage. It was good enough to go get it. Bring it back in. But there does need to be refurbishing done. A lot of times the stuff I bring off the street does need to be refurbished. Some of it needs a little bit more. Some of it needs a little bit less. But anyways, did that. There was a lot of sort of organizing work that needed to get done. So I got that. It's inside. It's drying now because it was raining outside. So you have to let it dry, particularly wood. You just let it dry and everything should be all right once it starts to dry properly. So I was supposed to film that today. I have it on the schedule to film today, but not happening. The reason why? Why am I shoving this off until the second? Simple. What happened is that yesterday, so I was starting to feel really, really good yesterday. I decided that I'll take a little trip around the library. And as I took the trip around the library to do a sort of a cursory overview, if you will, just sort of I call it strolling the stacks. The problem is when you start strolling the stacks like this, is that you often find things that you're interested in. And when you're working on problems, particularly in physics or whatever, however your research is laid out, and my research is all over the place because it is exploration of the universe, and so it entails a wide variety of things. So wandering the stacks is part of the way I sort of deal with, you know, the enormity of the project. Is I say, well, instead of picking a point, I'll just walk the aisles of the library, pick a point, and go from there. Well, I did. I didn't really expect to find much of anything, so I was just doing we call it perusing, if you will. But the perusing isn't exactly what I found. Or what I ended up with. I ended up with something more significant than a perusing. And, well, the usual result happened is that no eating, no sleeping, and I pushed myself right to the edge and I shouldn't have done that. So, everything is pushed forward because of the research project I did last night. I shouldn't have done the research project. I didn't intend to do the research project, but it sort of popped up as I was wandering the library stacks. And so the vlog on the music case, because I have to build what I got up there. I'll show you in the warehouse what I got, and I'll show you how we're gonna redesign it so that it will fit the role of a music instrument rack perfectly, right where the space where it needs to go. It's about 2 feet in width, the approximate size it's going to fit in there. So it's a good fit. It's a good thing in terms of the what I need. It just needs to be slightly adjusted, and I'll show you how we're going to do the adjustments. And in other words, you can see me do the freaking version of the IKEA thing. So, anyways, that's it for this segment of the BTS vlog. I will see you tomorrow, because by the time I get back to the next segment of the BTS vlog, it's going to be tomorrow, because it's 20 hours into the day of of Friday, right? It's 20 hours since the day of Friday. It's 20 hours of the day of Saturday, November 1st, right? Sorry about that. It's 20 hours into the day of Saturday, November 1st. That's where my problem is. My day is completely gone. Right? So with 4 hours from now, it's going to be Sunday. So anyways, I'll see you tomorrow. Take it easy. Bye-bye. Well, hello. It's an unusual hello, but then again, there's nothing usual about me anyway, so. Just fixing up myself something to drink here. Let's see, time and date stamp. Yes, that's right. Let's see, it is... here we go. It is 19 hours and 23 minutes into the day of Sunday, November 2nd, 2014. And I'm remaining fairly consistent with my logs. I mean, things could be better, but I think many things need improvement or could be improved. But perfection is never achieved around here, so status quo or good enough is often what we have. So, and even for me, my good enough is, you know, I've got a number of friends on YouTube here, and they're fairly young. They're still going out and trick or treating, and they're asking, who else goes out and does a trick or treating? And well, of course, I can't. I mean, I'd like to go out trick or treating, but. Who am I going to go out with? And I don't think they'd appreciate some of my age showing up at the door and saying trick-or-treat. So it really depends on the neighborhood. If there's a lot of people out, then yeah, you could do that. If there's not a lot of people out, then you can't do that. And I'm kind of in an industrial neighborhood, and I'd have to walk over to a residential neighborhood to do this. So it'd be... at least to get there, it'd be a 15-20 minute walk, and then do your trick-or-treating. So, but instead, what I do, I usually have my video marathon. I've got enough content on YouTube and the cartoons and the anime that I don't miss cable at all. I really, you know, people ask, well, what do you do now for TV that you don't have cable or whatever. Well, you've got enough content on YouTube, I've got enough anime, I've got enough cartoons that no real concern. But anyways, I went to my parents' house today for lunch and dinner. We had a combination birthday American Thanksgiving dinner. My nieces, who are Canadian, like the American Thanksgiving, the way the American Thanksgiving is done, as opposed to the Canadian Thanksgiving, and requested my parents, who do a lot of cooking, like I do a lot of cooking, that's why I have the kitchen diner, to have a Thanksgiving dinner. And because it's my birthday and my sister-in-law Sharon's birthday, they're very close. She's October 22nd, I'm the 29th. We combined everything together and had a birthday Thanksgiving dinner. And it was turkeys and the turkey and the whole bit. And, you know, done up real nice. So I got this Christmas card. I like the Christmas card because you can always do things with it that they're never intended. So normally you open it up and... and you hear a song, right? That's one of these song cards. It's got one of these song chips in it. So, but you can do it like this. You have to go. So, it can be annoying. So, the way you do it is, as soon as, you know, you get the card, and as soon as the person you want to annoy starts talking, you go. And You know, they stop, you know, you stop the car, you know. you can have fun with it. So, had a good day today. Hang around, talked. I finally got my brother onto Skype. He's an IT person, but he doesn't really like a lot of spending time on the apps. His idea of life is he does the work that he has to get done on the computer and stuff like that. And then the rest of the time is spent watching sports, particularly football, you know, hockey, stuff like that. That's his zest for life is sports. And, of course, he's, because I'm from Boston, he's from Boston, the whole family's from Boston. So he's a Boston fanatic. It's Celtics, it's the New England Patriots, which were originally the Boston Patriots. The Red Sox, Bruins, those are the majors for him. So he really does pay attention. He's heartbroken if something goes wrong. Gets to a point near the season the games are tight where he refuses to watch the game because if he does watch the game, it might be bad luck and they'll lose. And this, you know, that's sports. And so you can have fun. You can have fun with that every now and again. You know, you get to watch. You know, as long as the teams have been winning enough, then you can have fun with it. But if the teams haven't been winning, then, you know, you stay out of the line of fire, basically. That's what I've learned with sports fans. But anyway, it's been a pretty good day today. I've just been sort of milling around. I'm not going to start my back to work again, and I was supposed to not start break. I was supposed to not start my back to work schedule until Wednesday, but that has since changed. Things are improving, so I'm going to do my half schedule starting tomorrow on Monday, and go from there on out. There is enough to do, and I think I can get some editing done tomorrow. I probably will have to go out and try to do some food shopping, although, you know, we'll see, because I've already did cleaning in the warehouse over the weekend. That was a lot of heavy lifting, and I don't know whether it's a good idea or not to chance taking a walk tomorrow for food shopping, but we will see. I'm not sure how that's going to end up working out, so it could work out, but it could not work out. It's going to be a tricky thing. Because I do have things to get, but I'm sort of two minds about it, because it really depends on what's going to happen tomorrow in terms of the temperature. If the temperature's all right, I don't feel it's going to be too bad to walk. But if the temperature is, you know, if the weather is raining, then that poses more of a problem. So I'm going to have to sort of play it by ear. I don't know what I'm going to do. It's either going to be tomorrow or Wednesday I'll go shopping. I'll have to sort of wait and see. I know Mondays is not good. It's usually not good for shopping on Monday. So I'm going to wait till it's Wednesday and then go on Wednesday. So that's sort of the idea here. My Boston accent keeps slipping in every now and again. Tomorrow, back to a half. We'll start back to getting back on schedule again. I'll do schedule a half day for tomorrow. And we'll get to our list of things to do. All right, take it easy and have a good day. All right, bye-bye.
Welcome. I am the professor. And professor of what? Professor of physics.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light?
Free speech rules here at Democratic Earth.